Hello everyone. Again, we're coming to you from Bushi Lotus Reforming Manufacture. Today, we want to show you the all spare part for reforming machine and assembly processing for rollers, shafts, to make a complete reforming machine. So I start from here because in front of me you can see some gears motors. It has some electrical motor. You can see the information here. You can see voltage, frequency, power, ratio, and it's connected to gears to reduce the rotation and increase the power. For different machines or different design, we use a different gears, different electrical motor. You can see this gear is totally different from that one. That's directly connected to shaft. This one is 90 degree angle. And for gears also, you can see the information here. Let me show you the power, the ratio, everything else. So this is the electrical motor based on the thickness and rollers, stations, we use a different power. And here is the separate gearbox that we connected to roller shaft. These two parts connected together and connected to motor, this part connected to roller shaft for reforming. This tape, we tape A gears. It's a small gears, but the accuracy is too low. However, we can use it until 1.25 millimeters. Later I will show you the other gears tape. Here you can see the shaft. It has a already machining by lathe machine for nut coming here. Again, the secondary nut come here. Rollers, let me show you. You can see. And here is, it has some gap for putting the this one inside. You can see it can keep the roller to not move. Actually, this is not fit for this one, but something similar with this one. Here again, I show you some nut here, roller. You can see here again, rubber roller, and this side you can see the nut. Again, it has some machining part. Let me open it for you. You can see as you can see, you can make it tight, loose. And here all it has some number for change the distance. Here we use scarlet gasket. This is special shaft is going connected to inside to this shaft. You can see this one going to inside this shaft. We use this special design for reforming machine who wanna automatically change the one side roller. You can see if we call left side here, left side roller here, all has a this shaft. Then it connected to this right side. So once it wanna move, it can go inside and come back to other part by some gears motors.
So let's go to other part. Here I will show you the special gasket that we need. You can see up to the shaft design and shaft size, we use a different size of nut and gasket. It has this small clamp. Once it makes it tight and adjust it in the right position, we make it to this long, press it to this part of nut, then it cannot move anymore during working. So let's go to other parts. I already show you the shaft, roller, nut, gears, electrical motor. Here I will show you the electric cabinet, driver, PLC, R part is here. This machine is designed to put electrical cabinet inside. And here is all engineering, is now assembling the hydraulic station inside. Here we use the oil valve, and it's connected for input the oil here. Yeah, here is good, we can show you. We have a two side shaft, one here, I already told you, it's going inside to this shaft. One side is stable here, one side is movable, we use empty pipe. One by one, the roller going inside, based on the drawing that we have, and they read the drawing, so they realize which roller, which stations. Let me show you how they assemble the roller with shaft. First we clean it. You can see the, it's already connected to roller here. Yeah, let me show you the roller here. Our roller is already settled on here to later for assembly. They can one by one, left part, right part, assemble it to shaft here. You can see this machine is not automatic adjustable width, so the shaft is just one part. We don't have a separate shaft for left and right side. Roller, let me show you again. As I already explained to you, it has some number here, so they can realize by these number, okay, which station they should put. Later, if you have some maintenance or drawing, you can just read us this number. Let me show you this special roller. It has a special treating surface. For making the other surface for raw material in this shape. I will put it back. So let's go to machine frame structure, and let me explain to you different pillar stand that we use. This one, we call it a steel pillar. We produce here by hard chrome steel. It has a separate part, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 is here, connected to top of a roller here. After we put the down roller, we put this one to fix the down roller. All it has is this part, it has a whole joint part. Down roller joint here, you can see left and right side it has. Then we go to install the up roller, then we close it. And this hole we connect it to up roller to adjust the distance between the up and down roller. I want to show you other type of the pillow that we call casting pillow here. You can see it's already installed on machine. This one is casting pillow. The down housing bearings already fixed here. Inside has a bearing, you can see. Mostly we use a sky bearing. It has a cover here. For lotus forming or forming machine, we design and use parts according to your drawing and your budget. Different machine has a different body structure. Different machine, different drawing, you inquire us has a different pillar. You can see here why we use this kind of pillar for left side. Because this side shaft should be going inside and going out. So we use two roller, special bearing that can easily go in right and left for adjusting the width of profile. Here you can, I can show you again, different shaft. Let me show you that this is the up roller for connecting to this side. You can see, actually it's going to this side. Going kind of like this. It can come down and the operator going inside. Also the both sides should have the same bearing because left and down will move, left and right. Here is the complete steel pillar that just now I show you. It's already assembled here. You can see, as I already explained to you, one side of the roller stand can move by these gears, other side gears, guide rail here, it's connected with some agon here. So for various width sides, we use this kind of tape of basement stations. It can move left, right by PLC control, no need any special changing on rollers or shafts. Let me show you the complete machine here, but it's not painting yet. It's both part moved because the drawing should something like a U-shin and U-purling should be both start together move and coming more closer together. Let me show you the rollers. Here. Torque head. In the final, after final station of each roll forming machine, we need some torque head that you can twisting, going up, going down. By this screw, it can going up and going down. By this one, you can twist this one. You can see. Left feet and right. So here we are assembling some special roller related to your products and related to your drawing profile. Later, after the final forming come out, we can adjust the twisting and eyebrow shape by this torque head. We install it before cutting. Left station structure to moving by PLC and by these gears. These big screw is specially designed and produced in lotus forming manufacture that it can turn by these gears under PLC control to reach the gap and to reach the distance that we get. Here's the gears that we use. Each design, each shaft size has a different size of gears. It has a, it already passed the heat treatment. It can work line life per other parts. I'm searching here to what kind of part I didn't explain to you. So it seems all is already finished. So I will show you a whole view of our assembly parts here. Shaft, different machine shaft, roller. I show you the parts before assembling, the structure, shaft, rollers. Okay, it's enough for today. We hope you can see our videos and it will be useful for your manufacturing. If you have any further question for our forming machine or forming part, assembling, rollers, just feel free to contact us. Please subscribe us, YouTube at lotosforming.com. See you, bye.